Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So a few days ago, I made a video about a challenge that was posted on Twitter about reasoning with LLMs. So Victor Talin on Twitter had posted a challenge claiming that GPTs will be unable to solve the AB problem. And you can look at my previous video for a bit more context on what exactly the problem is. But basically, it is a rule-based rewriting problem. You set up a system with 4 tokens. There are some rules for rewriting sequences of tokens. And given an initial sequence of tokens, you want to keep applying these rules until you can't anymore. And that's your final answer. So Victor Talin had put up a $10,000 prize for anyone who can come up with an LLM prompt that achieves a 90%+ success rate on a 12 token sequence of this problem. The prize was claimed very soon after he actually posted this challenge, but the winning prompt was only revealed yesterday. So in today's video, I want to take a look at that winning prompt, analyze its structure, and see what we can learn from it. All right, so here's the winning prompt. Let's first go over it, and then we will analyze it. The initial part of it is set up with the persona, where you explain assistant is a careful and predictable step-by-step instruction following thing. And then you start explaining the problem. You're solving a string replacement logical puzzle where you apply transformations and you have these 4 tokens. And now you'll see that the problem statement becomes a lot more detailed and a lot more mechanical in terms of these are the mechanics to apply to solve the problem. It's not simply the original statement given in the challenge, which was fairly high level and more human readable. First of all, you'll see that the rules are now spelling out all 16 combinations of 2 token sequences. And they're even spelling out the trivial 1 token sequences, which don't get rewritten at all. They just stay as they are. There's a lot of stress on a few rules, like over here, you say when a sequence of tokens transforms into nothing, it's literally nothing, not even a space. And then you start showing the mechanics of how you would solve a problem instance. You rewrite old tokens to new tokens, and you apply rules one by one. You keep track of the index you're on. In the next step, you gather all the new tokens. There's some keeping count of the old tokens and new tokens. Then you check if the new string that you've just got by applying these rules is the same as the previous string, because then you can stop. That's your stopping condition. So that is the setup for the mechanics of how to solve the problem. So it's much more than just a high-level problem statement. Following that, this becomes a few short prompt with 5 examples that are fully spelled out. So it spells out in this textual format where for a few examples, it shows you what are the passes in which rules are applied. So in pass 1, this is how the rule gets applied. You gather the new tokens. After this pass, you get a different string than the previous one, which means you have to keep going. And this gets spelled out for a long time. Here's example 2. In all, this prompt has 5 examples, and that's the end of example 5. And we end with reinforcing some more guidelines. Make sure to complete every step perfectly without any mistakes, where all the important words are capitalized. This instruction here has to do with the original challenge, which specified that the output has to be between these solution/solution tags. Follow the rules I gave you and remember to index the values, so reinforcing that. Of course, we have some LLM classics like take a deep breath, and I will tip you $2,000 if you do everything perfectly. So that's the prompt that won the challenge. Now, what can we learn from this? The first lesson is that you really needed to spell out the mechanics of solving the problem in a very detailed way. The naive solution where you just took the initial statement of the problem had very low success rates. This detailed prompt had things like numbering the tokens, spelling out every step, gathering new tokens, keeping track of the indices, and then spelling out all combinations, not depending on simply the two or three rules that were in the initial problem statement. The next thing to note is that there's a lot of emphasis and repetition in the instructions. You have phrases like make sure, remember to do this perfectly. It gets rewritten to literally nothing, things like that. Another thing you'll notice, and this is related to the first point about spelling out the mechanics, is that the prompt lays out a textual format for how to write out the solution. So if you look at the way the mechanics are set up and the way the examples are spelled out in the few shot prompt, the prompt has a textual template of how to write out the solution. It's kind of like an elementary school problem workbook where you have fill in the blanks and there's a template of a solution. And then it is a few shot prompt. You have five examples that reinforce how these instructions are to be applied and computed out. And of course, we end with all these LLM classics like take a deep breath, I will tip you $2,000, and so on. So you really have to spell things out for the LLM. You can't just take the naive problem statement, at least for these kinds of abstract reasoning problems. The other thing to emphasize is that Futuristic Frog, who was the author of the winning prompt, had to do a lot of trial and error to arrive at the winning prompt. They say, I grinded for 11 hours straight, but it was fun. Took lots of pivoting and trial and error to create the prompt. And the winning prompt used Opus rather than GPT-4. Actually, a lot of the prompts that even came close to winning, the prompts that had a high success rate, were all made on Opus, Claude 3 Opus. One last thing I'll note is that it's actually very easy to get code to solve this problem. So if you simply give any decent LLM, whether it's GPT-4 or Claude or even Copilot in Visual Studio Code with GitHub, if you just gave it the initial problem statement, it would give you a Python solution that takes in a sequence of tokens in this AB system and applies the rules and gives you the final rewritten sequence of tokens. And it's pretty short. It's about 10, 20 lines of Python. So it's pretty easy to get code that solves this problem. Code from an LLM. Whereas if you wanted the LLM itself to solve it, you had to go through all these hoops and write this really long and detailed prompt. Now, I know that Victor Talin, the author of the original challenge, was trying to make a point about the limits of the kinds of reasoning that LLMs can do. And he was proven wrong in this case. But from a practical point of view, you've always got to consider the option of having the LLM write code to solve a problem rather than asking the LLM to solve a problem by itself. And there's many problems that fall into this category where you're much, much better off asking the LLM to use tools or to write code and then run the code to solve the problem. Anyway, so that was an interesting Twitter saga about LLM reasoning and how to construct prompts. I think we all learned something interesting from that. So thanks to Victor Talin for putting up the challenge. Congrats to Futuristic Frog for winning the $10,000 prize. I hope you all enjoyed that. If you like content like this, please consider subscribing, like the video, and I will see you all next time. Thank you very much.